Again, we're talking about ideal transformer here. The coupling value, which is m over the square root of L1 times L2, you want that to be close to 1, very close to 1. If you can get it close to 1, you have an ideal transformer. You get me nervous. I got to put all the dots on the inside now, Max. L1. No, he asked, does it make a difference if you put the dot on the inside or outside? So I don't think so, but try to be consistent because I change them all the time. So you know you have an ideal transformer. You have these lines in between them.
What do the lines signify?
This one?
Yeah, those two.
Ideal transformer.
Okay.
Once you see that, that's an assumption you have an ideal transformer.
Okay.
If you don't have them, they have to know the mutual inductance.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
So now we have V1 here. That's voltage 1. And we have V2 here. I'm going to give you like a scenario, what will happen if, because you asked the question. If I have I1 entering this way, and I2 entering this way, they're both entering the dot. The ratio here of the number of turns, we'll call them N1 to N2. You'll find out the ratio of V1 to V2 is the same as N2 to N1. And sometimes we define N2 over N1 as A. That's A to 1, you know, which is A. So A is really is N2 over N1. And the ratio of I1 to I2, when they're both entering the dot, is negative.
Backward.
Oh, I wrote them backward.
Yeah.
Backward.
Backward, backward, backward.
I was scared.
It's too early in the morning.
Yep. Backward. N1 to N2, which is 1 over A.
And was there a reason why you flip-flop both equations compared to the book?
I'm going to give you all the scenario. Our book is lousy on this subject. That's 1 over A, where A is defined as N2 to N1. What do you mean flip-flop them? I'm not sure.
If
but
you say V2 or V1 was A, it's not that big of a deal. You just did the exact. Like,
yeah.
Like
wait. So what's I1 to I2? Negative N2 to N1, which is negative A. Now, I don't know what our book does, but let me give you a scenario and tell me what our book has. Now, if I have I1, it says V1. And I1 is going this way. And now I'm going to have as ideal transformer. And what do you want, the dot on the top or the bottom? The dot on the top, like our book did, like this. And this is V2. Is that what our book had the picture? And I2 was going this way. Is that what we have there?
Yep.
Is that what we have for a picture? So now in this case, then V1 to V2, notice the polarity here. V1's plus where the dot, V2 plus where the dot. That's a positive. N2 to N1.
Actually,
oh, N1 to N2. Oh, yeah, I'm sleeping today. N1 to N2. And that's what? 1 over A. I1 to I2, the ratio. Notice here one current's entering the dot, the other current is entering the undotted. That would be a positive. Positive. N2 to N1, which is A. If you have a circuit, I'll give you all four cases. There's only four possibilities that can exist for this type of a problem. You want the dot on the top, both of them. Or we did the dots on the top, so let's do one on the top, one on the bottom. And this is I sub 1. This is I sub 2. This is V1. This is V2. Ideal transformer again. N1 to N2. I forgot to write N1 to N2 here. Let's look at the voltage. Notice here, V1, the plus is with the dot, but V2, the plus, is not with the dot, with the undotted. See that? So V1 to V2, let's see if I can write this correctly. It's negative N1 to N2. And if I can fit the current there, I sub 1 to I sub 2 is equal to what?
N2 over.
Are they both entering the dot?
Yes,
they both enter in the dot is negative. When they both enter, it's always a negative with the current. N2 to N1, which is negative A. Notice when they both enter the dot, the current is negative. And the last scenario that we could have is this one. This is I sub 1, but this is I sub 2. This is V1. This is V2. Ideal transformer, N1 to N2. In a case like this, notice V1 again. The dot is positive here. The dot is negative on this one. So the ratio of V1 to V2 is negative N1 to N2, which is negative 1 over A. And the ratio of I sub 1 to I sub 2, since one enters the dot, the other one, the undotted, that's positive N2 to N1, which is positive A. Does it make sense this way? All four scenarios.
Technically, wouldn't there be six because then all the dots would be on the bottom, but it would still be the same,
same
at the top, right?
Same, yep. Probability, two combinations for each one. Dot on the top, dot on, well, you can look at the voltage, the current, if you want to start breaking everything down,
no,
but
no, no,
yeah.
I
yeah. So let's take an example and see what will happen.
There's a certain one in the book you wanted to go over?
I'm going to make some because our book doesn't have any.
Oh.
Well, I can look and see if there's anything in our book. In the back of the book.
What about like at the end of the chapter?
Okay. There's one problem and what's the determine the average power, which we could do that. But let me find one. Oh, there's some actually. I'll go to the end of the chapter, grab one quickly. If not, I'll make one up. There we go. Calculate I sub 2, V2. Here's the question. Do we know what V? We have a circuit that looks like this as an example. The dot on the top. The ratio here of 1 to 6. 1 to 6. That means actually the one on the right has 6 times the number of turns on the left. We have a a load here, and Z load is given somewhere. There's twice they want us to do it, so I'll just do one of them, which is 1.5 angle 10. And we have the voltage V.
Angle 0, angle 10.
1.5 angle 10. And we have a voltage source here. That's V1, the value of that, 2 angle 118. I sub 1 is defined as going in. And I sub 2 is this current. The question here, see if I can find the question through these like 10 lines, they give you all the gibberish stuff. Calculate I sub 2 and V2. So here's V2. And here's V1. So calculate V2 and I sub 2. You're probably going to see we're going to have almost four equations by four unknowns. Let's look at KVL right here. If you do a loop here, KVL says what? What do we have? What's the voltage there? Negative, or negative 2 angle 118 plus V1 is equal to 0. Isn't it? If you do KVL right there. That tells me V1 equals what? It's in parallel with the source. I don't even have to do an equation. 2 angle 118. Now, actually, I know what V2 is. Notice how the polarity is defined. V1, the plus is on with the dot, and V2, the plus with the dot. So the ratio of V1 to V2, it is positive N1 to N2. So V1 to V2 is equal to the ratio of 1 to 6. 6 V1 equals V2, or V2 equals what? 1 6 V1. We know what V1 is from here. So what is V2? V2 equals 1 6 times 2 angle 118. Is that a third? Right?
Yeah.
Now, can I find where I sub 2 is? What's I sub 2? I sub 2 is the current right here. Exactly. I sub 2 is going to be V2 divided by Z. It's going to be V2, which is 1/3, 118, divided by, is that 3/2? 1 1/2 is 3/2, angle 10. I think that's 2/9, if you do the math, angle 108.
Wait, wouldn't the E2 equals 6V1 still? Like, why did you change it to E2 1.6 V1 at the end right there.
It's this number, right?
Like above when you're deriving the equation for it. V2 equals 1.6 V1.
Yep.
Shouldn't it still be V2 equals 6 V1? Because you didn't really do anything.
V2. Yeah, why did I change that? 1 times V2 is 6 times V1. 6 times. Sometimes I wonder if I'm asleep here. So 6 times 2, which is what? 12? Divided by 3 halves, or 1.5, is that an 8? 8. I don't know why I put 1.6 there. So if I know what ISIP 2, can I find ISIP 1? They didn't ask for it. Excuse me. Thank you. They didn't ask for ISIP 1. Can I find ISIP 1? Sure. What's the ratio of ISIP 1 to ISIP 2? Let's take a look at it. We have this current entering the dot, this current entering the undotted, so it's a positive. The ratio of N2 to N1. Let's see if I can cross multiply. ISIP 1 over ISIP 2 equals 6 over 1. So that means ISIP 1 equals what? 6 times ISIP 2. And what is 6 times 8? Is that a 48? Angle 108. So we found ISIP 1, ISIP 2, V1, V2, everything through that.
That's just because we have the ratio.
Yep. So that's it's not a bad problem. I made it simple enough. So let me make it a little bit bigger. I wanted to start with the straightforward one. So let's just make it a hair bigger. Let's take this problem. I can't see. 5 angle 0. You want to use RMS? We'll use RMS even. That's a resistor here. The value of 60. Comes down to this ideal transformer. The dot on the bottom for this, the ratio 4 to 1. This is 20. And this is 40. This is not in our book, just for the record, in case you look in the book. Let's do two things. Let's find, that's why I gave to you RMS, the average power supplied by the source. Delivered by the source, supplied by the source. And the average power delivered to the 20 ohm resistor. We'll do both. know what, I'm going to have fun with this. Let me do source transformation here. Remember source transformation? Let's bring it back. What's 60 times 5? 300 angle 0. Voltage source. That's 60. I decided, let's bring some of the stuff back from before.
We learned it.
Four to one.
So the fact that the bottom of those two coils are actually like connected now, that doesn't mess with the ratio
That's still an ideal transformer.
It has to do with this, the process has to do with in between the coils.
Right here, these guys are still ideal transformer. If I assign two currents here, I sub one this way, and I sub two that way, I have two equations by two unknowns. Well, actually, I have four equations by four unknowns. I'm going to call this voltage here V1, and I'm going to call this voltage here V2.
Why do you have four equations by four?
You'll see, because you're going to have, when you do KVL here, when you do a KVL here, right, Kirchhoff voltage law, you have negative 300 angle 0 plus, what's the voltage drop there? 60 I sub 1 plus V1 plus 20 times what? I sub 1 minus I sub 2 equals 0.
Oh, because there's...
There's V1, I sub 1, V2, I sub 2. Yep. So when you clean that one, we have 300 angle 0. Equals, what do we have? 60 I sub 1 up at you plus 20, that's 80. 80 I sub 1 minus 20 I sub 2 plus V1. That's one equation. One equation, three unknowns, doesn't do me any good. Let's go to the right side. The right side, we have what? 40 I sub 2 plus 20 times. What's the current through that?
I sub 2 minus I sub
1, yes. Minus V2 is equal to 0. Because V2 is defined plus to minus. So clean that, negative 20 I sub 1 plus, what, 60 I sub 2 minus V2 is equal to 0. That's my other equation. Now I got two equations by four unknowns. None of us can solve that. But we can find the ratio of V1 to V2. What's the ratio of V1 to V2? It's ideal transformer. Notice where the dot is. The dot with the plus sign, the dot with the negative. That's a negative N1 to N2. It's always V1, V2, N1, N2. The numbers are matching. One on the top, two is on the bottom for the voltage. The current's always backward. So in this case, V1 to V2, what's the ratio of that? Negative 4 over 1. Which says what? V1 equals negative 4 V2.
So the current in this case would have been positive.
Let's look at the current there. Nick said, what about the current? The ratio of I sub 1 to I sub 2 is going to be N2 to N1. The only question is, it positive or negative? Well, let's see. This current entering the dot and this current entering the dot. When they both enter the dot, it's always negative. So here, when you simplify this, I1 to I2 equals negative, what was N2? Is it 1 to 4?
Yes.
So I2
equals 4I1.
Negative 4I sub 1, right? So now if you do these two quick substitution back here, you will shrink that to two equations by two unknowns. You could make it four equations by four unknowns. I sub 2 is negative 4 I sub 1. That would be 80 and 80, 160. 160 I sub 1 minus 4 V2 is equal to 300 angle 0. This one here, 60 times negative 4, that's, what's that? 240, negative 240. Negative 260 I sub 1 minus V2 is equal to 0. Do we have an answer now for, we know what V2 equals to if I did that right. It's negative 260 I sub 1. Plug it in. And you know what I sub 1 is. That would be a plus 4 times 260. I hope that's a 260. Where's my calculator? Four times 260. 4 times 0, 0. 4 times 6, 24. 4 carry 2. There's 1,040. Did you get V1 equals 260?
Yep.
260 volts RMS. You know what V2 now? V2 divided by negative 4. So we divide it by negative 4, what do we have? 1/3, is that 65? Yep. Let me just take a peek at the picture. Was the dot on the top? Yeah, so I got negative 65. I sub 1, did you get 0.25?
Yep.
25 amps RMS. And I sub 2 is going to be times negative 4, that's a negative 1. So if you solve your four equations by four unknowns, you're in good shape.
And the question was looking for
the power supplied
by the source.
By the source, yep. So let's go back and see. The 220 is easy to find what the average power absorbed by the 220. We find out what the current through it. And we go from there. So let me get back to my circuit here, my original one.
Did you say the current through the... Oh, sorry.
Yep. On the source transformation there, if the resistor and the current source flipped initially, could you still
do the source transformation? If the
resistor...
Those? Yeah. Sure. Doesn't matter if they were pretty, you can flip them back in parallel.
It really doesn't matter.
Yep. So if the resistor was here, the current there, you can still put them back in this configuration.
Because I was asking that.
Yep.
Yeah.
With
source transformation, I got some screwed numbers, so...
Yeah, so
ready, guys?
So it says to find it through the source. That's the 5.
That's this source, yep. So let's go back to that.
5R.
Let's look at the power delivered to the 20 ohm. That's the easy one.
So we don't have to do the 20, and we don't have to change the 300 back, right?
Nope. So we got I sub 1 coming down. We got I sub 2 going up for that. So if you want the current coming down, it's going to be what? I sub 1 minus I sub 2. What was I sub 1?
0.25.
Minus, what was I sub 2? Is that a 1?
-1.
That'd be a plus 1.
1.25.
So that's 1.25, the current through that 20 ohm resistor. Average power, this is RMS value, right? So the average power delivered to the 20 ohm resistor, it's VRMS, IRMS. Or, you say cosine theta V minus theta, theta I, there is no phase shift between them, it's a resistor there. That's a zero, cosine of zero. And Ohm's law says V equals I times R, so that's I squared times R. I is what? 1.25 square root times the 20. Is it 31.25 watts? Now, let's go back and find out what was the average power delivered by the source. Let's look at the source. Here's what I know right now from the math I just did. Bless you. Bless you. From the math I did, I sub 1, is the current really going this way? This is I sub 1. And I have a value for that. What was the value? 0.25? V1 is the voltage right here. What was V1? V1 is 260 volts right here. And we know the voltage right here. So if this is my ground, what's the voltage right here? We just calculated the current through that. The current was at what? 1.25. Remember that? 1.25 going down times 20 is going to mark that what? What's 20 times 1.25? Is that 25? There's 25 volts. So let's think about this. This is ground. What's the voltage on the top then?
25.
25. What's the voltage way on the top? 25 plus 260. 25 plus 260, which is what?
285.
285, is it? Mm-hmm. So the voltage here is 285 volts. This is zero.
Uh-huh.
This is 25, which is the current times that resistor.
Mm-hmm.
So this end is 25 higher than that end. 25 higher than zero is plus 25. This end is 260 volts higher than this.
Because
260 is higher than 25, which is 285. So what's the average power delivered now to the load there? I mean, delivered by the source? Oh, where's my sheet of paper? P delivered by the 5 amp source. It is VRMS IRMS cosine theta V minus theta I. VRMS, which is 285, the angle is 0. IRMS is 5. Cosine theta V happens to be 0 minus theta I, which is 0. Theta I was given to me to be 0, and theta V happens to be 285 angle 0. There's no angles here. What's cosine of 0? 1. What's 285 times 5?
1,425.
1,000? What
was
it? 425. 425 watts. Usually when it's delivered, what do we say for a sign?
Negative.
Because being delivered, supplied. So the minus means it was delivered.
Wait, why is it minus?
Minus always means delivered, plus means...
No, why is it? So why is it a negative? Because if you do 285 times 5, it's positive. Where did the negative come from?
Because you got... a negative current, I mean a positive current entering the negative end of the voltage. A positive current entering the negative end of the terminal, that's always a negative. So you should have here a minus. The minus again indicates it was being supplied. So that's what the minus sign tells you. It was supplied, not delivered to. It's delivered by. Supplied or delivered by. So that's what the minus sign tells us. Okay. What time is it? Shoot. I was about to do this problem. I don't have time for it.
We'll give it to us when we do it.
Yep, you can work on this.
Yeah, do that.
Make this our homework assignment.
Yep. Ready, guys?
Homework assignment.
I was about to do that, but I don't have any time for it. So it's yours now.
Well, the number is in the book.
It's not in our book. I'm just making thing up. Ideal, the ratio 1 to 25, and this is 10.
That's
the dot here actually went on the bottom. Let's put the dot on the bottom here.
You're really stepping up here, Z.
There's another one.
That would be a step up.
Right? Oh, come on.
What if I'm a little bit like that? No way.
And the ratio is 1 to 4. Now, quickly, if I was doing this, I have about maybe a minute and a half. I sub 1. I can probably write the equation. I sub 2. I sub 3. This is V1, V2, V3, and V4. Find the average power delivered. The 20 ohm. Where's the 20 ohm? There's no 20 ohm.
4 ohm.
Four, probably the 4 ohm, right?
You're looking at the different problem. You made this one up, remember?
Oh, yes.
It's from last.
What do you want us to find?
The average power. This is, let's say that's a 4K here, because that would be a small value, 4 ohm. Let's say the average power delivered to that 4K. But if I was doing this again, I look at KVL right here. I go 100 angle 0 equals 10 I sub 1 plus V1. That's one equation. I look on the outside one. I see what? 4K I sub 3 minus V4 is equal to 0. Then I got lots of problems. You get I sub 1, V1, I sub 3, V4 with two equations.
So there's 7?
Let's look at V1 to V2 here. Notice here, the polarity is positive with the dot, negative with the dot here. See it? So that's a negative.
N1 to N2,
which is negative 1 over 25. That's the first equation. V2 equals negative 25 V1. The ratio of I sub 1 to I sub 2. Notice both entering the dot. That's a negative. N2 to N1. Negative 25 over 1. So I sub 1 equals negative 25 I sub 2. So right now we have four equations. We're not done. We have six unknowns. We need six of them. Let's look at V3 and V4. The ratio of V3 to V4. Notice here that V3, the plus with the dot. V4, the plus with the dot. Can you see them? That's positive. 1 to 4. So that means V4 equals 4V3. And the last equation, the ratio of I sub 2 to I sub 3. I know it's going to be 4 to 1, but is it positive or negative? This current entering the dot, this current entering the undotted, so that's what? Positive or negative? One enters the dot, one enters the undotted. That's a positive. Well, let's see, what do we have? We have I sub 3, I sub 2, I sub 1, that's three of them. V1, V2, V3, V4, 1, 2, 3, 4, yep, 7. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
But I too.
Yeah.
We get I sub 2?
Oh, no, wait, never mind. Did we do I1, I2?
We did I1, I2. Oh, you can do one right here. KVL through this loop, right?
Yeah, yeah, that's fine.
So negative V2 plus V3 is equal to 0.
So V2 is equal to V3.
Yep, V2 equals V3. Then parallel. So now if you do all these quick substitution, there's no unknowns left there. So your homework is done. 2 minutes.
Thank you.
Seven equations by seven unknowns. What we're going to do next time, what happens if you have a load you want to find the equivalent to that circuit? We'll do that next time. Then we are done with transformers after that.